Hey, welcome back out to the farm on this beautiful day. Nice and sunny, about 70 degrees. Just couldn't ask for a better day. And we're here to take a look at the UUQ Prince 5. UUQ did send this out to me, so they wanted me to do a little review here, and that's what we're going to do. And so far, it's held up really nicely. I've sighted this in and did that intro. So all in all, about 100 rounds so far. Not that much, actually. Probably 60 rounds, something like that. And so far, it hasn't budged or anything, so, and it's definitely holding zero. So that's nice. This right here is a 7.62x39 AR-15. And I like to do testing on this AR right here because it's chambered in 7.62x39. 7.62x39 is a little bit heavier hitting than, you know, your typical AR-15 cartridge, which is the 223/556. So this one produces a little bit more recoil, and I think it's a good test for optics to make sure that they stay zeroed and stay tight, don't fall off the gun, you know, don't come loose or anything like that. And so far, this Prince 5 right here has really been holding up. So just real quick, the rifle here, it is a custom build. We got a KP-15 lower. Is it KP? Yeah, KE Arms KP-15. And I really like this lower right here. It's just nice and lightweight. It's all one piece, and the grip feels nice. And again, with something like the 7.62x39 cartridge, it's definitely holding up just fine with a lot of recoil. So these KP-15 lowers are really nice. I've got a couple of them, as a matter of fact. And we've got here a 20 round mag, got a couple of other mags. Everything is YouTube compliant, so please just calm down. This is a 20 round mag, and the other one I'm going to bring out is a 28 round mag. And these are made by C Products, I believe. I took off the base plate because I've got these Ranger plates, these Magpul Ranger plates on here. You know, you don't always need to carry 30 rounds or 28 rounds. Sometimes something like a 20 round mag, especially with the added weight of the 7.62x39. It's just kind of nice. I think it gives this rifle right here a really nice profile. And with this UUQ Prince 5 right here, which is kind of like an Aimpoint H1 knockoff in a way. You know, these are very ubiquitous, this kind of a design. You can find a lot of these on Amazon or just on the internet or whatever for around the $40 to $80 price range. This right here is right in the middle at about $60. And I think it's very high quality. It comes with this mount right here, which is a co-witnessing mount, and it does co-witness with the iron sights. I've got some Magpul MBUS2 sights, and it co-witnesses just fine. We'll go ahead and test that out here in a sec. But aside from that, oh yeah, just real quick, got right here a Odin Mini right here, Olight Odin Mini, with a pressure switch, so very easy to actuate. And everything. And anything else about the rifle I should mention? I don't really think so. This muzzle brake right here is a really great muzzle brake. I think it's made by KAK and or KAK, however you pronounce it. And it really does a good job of directing the gases upwards and keeping the barrel actually kind of pointed downwards a little bit. So under the heavy recoil of a 7.62x39, this muzzle brake makes this rifle a very flat shooting rifle. Because even though it kind of pushes down the muzzle a little tiny bit, it's really easy to just bring it back up and get some rapid shots off and stay on target. So, all right, back to the Prince 5 here, though. It also has a shake-awake feature, or motion-awake. I believe there's a lot of different names out there for kind of the same thing, but I believe this is a 4-minute shutoff. And we're going to actually do a closer look at this on the tabletop. So if I'm incorrect about any of the information, I'll go ahead and correct that in the tabletop part of the video. But I have actually tested it out, and it does go off after 4 minutes. And then as soon as you pick it up, you know, move it a little bit, it comes right back on. The dot itself is actually pretty crisp. Right now I have it up on, I think, like the highest setting. And there's no glare. There's really no glare at all, actually. Kind of looking side to side. The dot does a really good job also of just kind of staying center. So yeah, I mean, quality wise, this thing has been doing really well. Let's go and take some shots here. I'm at 36 yards, and that's where I like to zero all of my red dots. You know, any optic that has like a one magnification, and that's just a good all around zeroing distance, because you can basically shoot from, you know, anywhere from 1 yard all the way out to about 300, 350 yards with only like an 8-inch difference in elevation. So I like it a lot. And right now we're going to go ahead and take a few shots and see if I can hit the target. And we're just shooting some Tula, by the way. I've been sitting on cases of Tula for years now. I'm still only shooting about 20 cents a round right now, which is so nice in today's climate. But yeah, this is some Tula. I'll also say real quick that I did replace the firing pin with an enhanced firing pin, so you get a little bit of extra length out of the firing pin part that protrudes out of the bolt face, and just really ensures that it hits those primers, those hard primers that Tula comes with, as well as the fact that I have a really hard hitting trigger in here. However, it's a really nice trigger. It's that Geissele 3-gun trigger. I forgot exactly what it's called, but I think it's like the 3-gun or something like that. It's not only very smooth, but it's also very light. And aside from it being very light, it has full power springs. So you're not really feeling the full power springs. You're really hitting that primer with that firing pin with a lot of force, which will then hit the primer. And so far, it's been 100% reliable. So let's get the shooting. Yep, I already loaded it up. All right, 36 yards. That little target down there, I think it's a 3-inch target, something like that. We got a 3-inch target. I think it's like a 5 to 6-inch target in the middle. And then there's I think that's a 10-inch target at the end. And the 10-inch target's no problem to hit, as long as I can shoot well. Not like that. Load up another mag. I forgot them over there, so give me one sec. All right, so this is that 28 round mag, and it's actually downloaded to only 25 rounds just because I'm only spending 20 cents a round on these. I still want to save some money, so I'm not going full mag, just 25 rounds, slightly downloaded. But yeah, let's go ahead and do some co-witnessing, as a matter of fact. We'll see how that does. I can still see the target just fine through the viewfinder, or the whatever you call it, through the red dot itself. I could see the iron sights. I'm knocking off all my targets over there. So yeah, let me go fix those. Gosh darn it. I was kind of wrong on the target sizes. I just measured them. They're actually a 3, a 5, and an 8-inch target. I don't know why I thought they were a little bigger, but you know, I mean, guys, they always like to think it's a little bigger, right? You know, like a, you know, 8 to 10 inches. I mean, the target, that's what I'm talking about. 8-inch target. That's average. It's an average size target. I mean, I think there's still probably about 20 rounds left in that mag. So we already did the co-witnessing. I think we can put the iron sights down because I proved that you can definitely see through the optic co-witnessing your iron sight. So let's just do some regular shooting here. I'm having a hard time hitting that little 3-inch target. And I think my targets are, they kind of need a little bit of a makeover. I need to rechain them. I'm kind of using a bunch of broken chains right now to keep them up, but I just need to go to the store and get some new chains. Probably some new fittings as well. All right. Four more shots. I've got right here, this is just a 10 rounder, nice cute little mag, but I think it gives it a really nice sleek profile, kind of like a target rifle at this point. It is accurate. Just because I can't hit every shot has nothing to do with the sight itself or the gun itself, it's because I'm not that good of a shot, but I'd say I'm an average shooter with an average size target down there. Just average me, you know, whatever. Do you see that? Piece of grass went flying up. All right, I hit the little target. There goes the middle one. Nice. Hit the little one again. Got three rounds here. Nice. That's all right. I think it's staying zeroed. I think it's staying zeroed just fine. Again, I'm the one that kind of sucks. It's not really the optic. It's on there. I mean, it's tight. So let's go ahead and go back inside and we'll take a closer look here at the UUQ Prince 5. All right, welcome back everybody. So we're just gonna take a closer look here real quick at this UUQ Prince 5 upside down. No, I'm just kidding. Here you go. So it held up just fine from what you could see from the shooting footage. It held zero. It didn't come loose or anything like that. So that's mostly from what you can ask for, you know, for a budget red dot in this kind of a price range, which right now on Amazon is going for about $53. And there's actually a clickable 8% coupon as well. And I did the math for you guys. That's $4.25 off. So for less than $50 right here, you can grab yourself a UUQ Prince 5. And I think I kind of compared this to like the Aimpoint H1, something like that, H1, H2, but it's also reminiscent of something like a Hollow Sun. You know, just because it's typical doesn't mean it's bad or anything. It gets the job done. This right here is like the Honda Civic of the red dot world. It gets you from point A to point B, and that's really all you got to ask for out of something that costs about $50. So I did go over a few features in the shooting footage, and I just want to reiterate some of those. First of all, something I kind of forgot to mention, it is a 2 MOA dot. It does have a 4-minute shake awake feature or motion awake feature, and I believe it's a 20 millimeter lens. Since it's attached to the rifle right now, I don't think I'm really going to be able to show you the dot. That's going to be tough to do, but it's a relatively crisp dot. I'm not going to say it's super crisp or anything like that. Again, it's a budget dot. And when I was outside using this, I had it turned all the way up to 11, which is the highest setting. And more than likely, you'll never use settings 1 through 4. Really, I think it's kind of funny that these companies turn their dots up to 11. Obviously, they've never seen this is Spinal Tap.
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly. One louder.
Why don't you just make 10 louder and make 10 be the top number and make that a little louder?
These go to 11.
Nothing, of course, against that. You always want to have a little extra power, but why not make it 1 through 10? But all in all, the performance was absolutely great. It's a pretty rugged optic. It was standing, or holding up, I should say, to this 7.62x39 chambered AR-15. A pretty decent amount of recoil. You know, 7.62x39 is definitely no slouch when it comes to recoil. So this thing had no issues whatsoever that I could say. I actually don't really have any cons of any kind. You know, I did kind of say there was a little, like, bleed off for the dot. That's hardly noticeable. But again, at less than $50, you really can't go wrong. This is a great optic. So I'm trying to think if there's any other features in general. It's pretty lightweight. Oh, yeah, of course, the mount. So this is a co-witness mount. I believe it's an inch riser, something like that. Right? Inch riser? Maybe inch and a half? I don't know. But anyways, the point is that you can co-witness with your standard iron sights. So something very ubiquitous like these Magpul MBUS 2 sights, or really any, you know, standard iron sight, it's going to do just fine. I really do like these adjustments. It's nice that it's tool-less, so you just unscrew the cap here, and then you can use the top of the cap to adjust the sights. And it has some pretty good clicks. First of all, the threads are very smooth, but you can use the top of the cap right there, as you can see with that little notch. And then, here, listen to this. Very nice, audible, tactile clicks. So, battery. So this is a 2032 battery. Again, a very common battery, so I'm sure most of y'all, if you're anything like me, have plenty of those lying around. It does come with one battery, though, so you don't have to worry about it. Straight out of the box. And I think it has something like 50,000 hours of battery life, probably on the low setting. So even if you're using it on the high setting, you're still going to get plenty of battery life. And then if it runs out of battery, hey, you know, just pop in another one. It's not too hard. One thing that I didn't test, though, but it does say that it is IPX7 waterproof rating. So that basically just means that you can dunk it in the water and it should be fine. But if you submerge it, I think, any more than like a meter or something like that, you might have a little bit of seepage into the dot. So, you know, just don't go snorkeling with your Prince 5, and I think you should be fine. And then the housing, as well as the mount itself, is made of aluminum alloy. So there's no plastic at all on the dot. Or on the optic at all. So it's pretty heavy duty, or not heavy duty, but it's well made. Like I was saying before, pretty rugged. I just tend to leave the cover off, and I don't really think that you're going to scratch it up too much. If you're going in the war with your firearm and you're worried about the lens getting scratched up, you know, do yourself a favor. Just get a high quality red dot, right? Something like a Hollow Sun, something like an Aimpoint, something like a Trigicon. Spend the money, and you'll be just fine. But for the average shooter, I'd say, even more than just plinking around, but even like home defense, recreational shooting, target shooting, all that kind of stuff, this would hold up just fine. And I don't think you're really going to mess it up too much. So right here is the box. I do like these boxes a lot. They do just fine. It came with wrapped up in the plastic bag. And comes with a couple Allen wrenches to torque everything down. You've got your, instructions and lens cloth. A little snack for later. It's my favorite part. And then right here is the low profile mount. So in case you want to take this down a little bit, I do actually like having up on this high profile mount, even if I'm not using the iron sights at all. Like if this was on a gun without iron sights, I would still probably use this mount right here. But just in case, you know, for example, at something that has a higher rail, something like an AK-47, whatever, you know, something along those lines, something that's not an AR-15 that has a slightly higher rail from where the buttstock kind of hangs down a bit.
something like this little profile mount, I think, would work just fine. So that's going to just about do it. I do have this dot right here on the table. This is another UUQ site, and I really do like this one a lot. This is like an SRO knockoff, and this one's been doing awesome. But usually I have it on the quick detach mount that's, I think, a half inch riser. So usually it sits about right there, which, as you can actually see, the lens part is basically on the same exact elevation. So UUQ keeps surprising me. They did send this one out, and they wanted me to do an honest review, and I honestly don't really have too much, anything bad to say about it. Again, for the price range, like, what is there bad that you can say about it? Anybody who's nitpicking this thing has no idea what they're talking about. So don't listen to those guys. Just listen to this guy, right? Okay. Anyways, that's going to do it. So thanks for watching.